Toxic relationships are the worst type of relationship anyone can find themselves in. They drain your energy and leave you feeling sad. According to Time magazine, a toxic relationship is any relationship between people who don't support each other, where there's conflict and one seeks to undermine the other, where there's competition, where there's disrespect and a lack of cohesiveness. Toxic relationships, by their very nature, don't last very long. They usually end up in breakups and divorce. You really don't want to be in a toxic relationship. There are some things that can help you detect whether your relationship will be toxic going forward. In today's video, I am going to discuss 7 early signs of a toxic relationship. If you're new here, consider subscribing to my channel for more awesome videos such as this one. 1. Dishonesty. Ask yourself, when did he start lying to you? Can you remember? If you can't, it is probably because it's been so long you can't remember anymore. Don't get me wrong, women lie too. It is a fault both genders share equally. Dishonesty is a clear sign that the relationship has begun heading downhill. How long are you willing to keep fighting for what is no longer there? Once either of the two of you start lying, trust leaves the relationship. I know it sounds unfair when it may not have been you who is lying. However, what do you do about the fact that you can't believe anything your partner says because you suspect they are not telling the truth? If you notice this early, talk to your partner about this. A relationship is something built on understanding by both of you and a period of commitment. Talk to them about it and air your concern. Chances are, if you talk about it, you guys may be able to resolve the issue. But if they continue, you may need to cut your losses. There are just some things not worth fighting for. 2. Unreliable partner. Does he promise to pick your mom up and forget? Does he forget your birthday often? While this may actually be pretty normal, suppose a person works as a high-level executive in a consulting firm like McKinsey. In that case, it means that they probably won't even remember their own birthdays because they are too busy drafting proposals and preparing presentations. If this is not the case and they seem to perfectly remember everything relating to them and just never remember the one that concerns you, you have to rethink the relationship. When was the last time you planned a trip and he just never remembered to pack and had to cancel the last minute? What exactly have you entrusted him with that he eventually succeeded in doing? If the answer is none, it may be time to let go. People generally go out of their way to help those they care about. If they are not doing this in any way with you, it can only mean one of two things. Either they actively don't care about you or are indifferent about the relationship. Ask yourself, what do you really want? Someone who is just in a relationship and passing the time, or someone you can work with to build a future? Remember, you get to choose. Only you can determine your happiness. No one can. 3. Unwillingness to commit. More often than not, you have people who want to have all the benefits of a relationship and not partake in any of the commitments. No one, of course, should be coerced into commitment. But when you can clearly see that they have zero intentions of doing this, you're better off alone than continuing such a relationship. People can be scared. Commitment is a big word and means a whole lot of things. It can mean mandatory checking up and phone calls. It can mean talking about long-term goals and short-term goals. It may even involve talking about student loans and your jobs. Some people actually just like being private. That is fine. But then relationships require a certain level of openness between the parties. They need to feel comfortable with each other in order to start off on the right foot. Whether or not the relationship works out though, it is still up to them. Some couples can both be unwilling to commit and later become willing. People that are willing may also become unwilling. There's really no signs to it. If you are in a relationship, try to communicate better with your partner. Imagine a scenario where a lady called Rose has dated the same guy called Chase for 6 years and he basically treats her the same as he did when they first met with indifference. Rose has been working very hard to please him. He moved into her apartment and hasn't contributed to the rent or groceries even though he earns higher. Rose just keeps hoping and hoping. If you know Rose, is she really real? I will ask you to sprinkle some water on her to wake up. She needs to open her eyes to her reality properly. Chase has used and is using her. 4. Self-absorbed partner. The people in the relationship who are this way are usually not very interested in the relationship. This is hard as a result of infidelity. Many self-absorbed partners are faithful, but they are incredibly selfish. According to Couples Institute, some of the biggest challenges are how easy it is to side with a partner who is not very self-absorbed, whether or not differentiation is possible when self-absorbed partners show so little interest in their spouses, the plight of the partner who feels invisible and lonely, how to change the core selfishness. If your partner is like this, you may have to start to reconsider the relationship. It is really not worth it to stress yourself over a person whose interest lies solely on themselves. Such people are better off alone. They do only things that directly benefit them and are unwilling to make compromises in the relationship. Why exactly are you still with them? You need to look beyond the emotional connection and think about your own mental health. You too deserve to be happy. Are you happy right now in your relationship? If there were two things you could do today to take away the stress, what would it be? You have to be honest with yourself and think about what's best for you too. 5. Manipulative outburst. Some people are very manipulative in the relationship. They want everything to go their way, so they use manipulative tactics to get what they want. Whether you can spot them or not is dependent on whether you know their tactics. One way you can protect yourself is by being less empathetic and more assertive in the relationship. Psychology Today offers some advice. Being overly empathetic puts you in jeopardy of being mistreated again and again. Manipulative people are either passive or aggressive, but the result is the same for the victim. You can feel abused or used depending on the type of manipulation you are exposed to. Psychology Today offers some guardians on what may happen. They may lie or act caring or hurt or shocked by your complaints, all to deflect any criticism and to continue to behave in an unacceptable manner. Manipulative partners are very toxic to be with. They often don't know what they are doing, but you are too hot to care anymore. They are likely going to inflict more pain in you if you stay with them. 6. They belittle your feelings and interests. Does this sound familiar? It does to me. I have met people who are this way. Does your current partner make you feel really small? Does he make side comments about your hair, your dressing, and your weight? If he does, this is a clear sign the relationship with him is toxic for you. But of course, you may not accept that. No one does that easily. But you need to ask yourself what type of future you have with a person who doesn't respect you or your interests. Typically, such people also want you to accept their own recommendations on clothing, food, and other things. When you have had time to reflect on this issue, make a run for it. A relationship headed in that direction will only lead to tears. You deserve better. How long do you think you can keep up, and why do you keep trying? Even if the person decides to change, it will take a while, and the tendency to revert is still there. Unless you have been together for such a long time, you are willing to make it work, it is advisable you don't try at all. 7. They complain when you can't help out with something. Some partners in a relationship can feel very entitled. They feel entitled to your time. They feel entitled to your resources. They feel entitled to your intellect. You cannot have anything in the world more important than them and their problems. They will make you feel guilty for choosing yourself while forgetting that asking you to be exclusive with them against your own interest is in itself selfish. You really should not mix up with those type of people. People like this will take you for granted. Imagine making a sacrifice for someone and having them complain about the quality of your sacrifice. You need to breathe. Some people can make you feel so small and vulnerable. They can make you lose your self-confidence and courage to do things. You can't even keep someone like that as a friend. They will ruin you. The smartest way to deal with them is to ignore them and choose yourself. When you stay doing that, you will see them running after you and begging you for your time because they were really dependent on you, and as long as you were under their control, they were happy.